happened something for me just recently, within the last year. I was going with the tram, Straßenbahn, in Gothenburg. And there was a young woman. She raised herself and offered me a sitting. And I was thinking, wow, I have become old. It was really... So maybe I should talk about old age a little, because I also noticed in the last years time goes very fast. I mean, the days goes fast, week goes fast, and suddenly 1 year has gone. And I ask I have a little restaurant, and I sometimes ask my guests, what did they do with the time? I think it goes faster nowadays, and they sometimes agree. But it's an illusion, because we know this material world, or this life, is very, it's mystical, very mystical. Something happens, we cannot figure it out with our intelligence. We think we can figure it out, but it's very, very complicated, and we have many experiences. Personal experience, and also experience from others. So it's quite important. And another thing also, I noticed also when we do devotional service, even if we have not so important service or whatever we do, every day in the restaurant there is something good happening. Some people come in, just small things come, small things happen. And I feel that also nowadays, also Guru Maharaj talked a little in the morning here about big things and small things, but I appreciate nowadays also just small things happening in the meeting with some people or different people. So we should not also be, and I also sometimes devotees or young devotees or new devotees have become a little shy to present themselves as devotees, or a little shy. They think they cannot speak something, but my experience is that if one speaks from one's really, what one has heard and some realization, and even if it's against the main atmosphere in the society, people will appreciate. So we should never feel ourselves unqualified, because we are work in progress. We cannot expect that we hide away and then suddenly we should become perfect. No, we have to practice and practice and practice. So this is... very important, I think, to not be shy. I don't know if maybe you're not shy, but I see sometimes devotees become a little shy from speaking about Krishna consciousness. So this is, and we know also know that in this age, what age we are in?
Kali Yuga.
Yeah. Kali Yuga. It's we should not blame Kali Yuga, but we should understand that Kali Yuga is here. So, but at the same time, we should we always have Lord Chaitanya behind, who is supporting us. It's a golden age even now. Everyone is looking for the golden age, but actually, the future is now. What we do now, that is our future. So whatever we do now for Krishna or for others, devotees, that will be our future. But if we are shy or we don't go forward, then nothing will happen in the future also. Another thing also, if one is a little hesitant to do something, to start something. Of course, one should not rush into something, but when I started this small restaurant, I had been thinking about it for a long time. But yeah, I was also hesitating, but at one point I was thinking, no, I just do it. Even if I didn't feel that I had the energy, or it was also a special place, I could not cook in there, but I took the place anyway. And somehow or other, I got offered to cook in another restaurant because I knew I had met one person who had a restaurant before. Many years before, I just happened to meet him. So when you start something, so if you have been thinking about something for some time, then just go ahead, because that will always happen. You will get help in a mystical or unexpected way. That's and I want to finish my little talk with.
No, questions.
Okay.
You finish your talk and then we ask you. Okay.
Okay. Yes. This is my one of my. I don't know. Yeah. I would like also. Yeah. To encourage you, everyone here, to learn verses. It happened a long time ago in the middle, no, long time ago in my Krishna consciousness. So I learned a few verses. I remember one verse in the car ride to Stockholm and one day. And that time I was my body was quite young. So I learned that verse and I still remember it. So when you are young now, you should learn verses. Because I try now also to learn verses, but it's more difficult. So even it's difficult also when you're young, but you have to train very nicely. And then in the end of life you will have so many. And in these verses is not for... These verses comes up in your personal life also. When something happened, and then you can connect with some verse. It comes up. And then you, because this material world is very confusing, we know that, isn't it? Or, it's very confusing. Krishna says also, it's very difficult to overcome this material world, or this Maya. But, these verses, one should try really to learn verses from Bhagavad Gita. And it's also nice for preaching, because people... We say, some devotees say that maybe this age is difficult to preach in this age. But I my experience is that people are interested in spiritual things. But they maybe not want to join some organization or something. But just to give out this knowledge from Bhagavad Gita and from Srimad Bhagavatam, it's very effective. And... that's what I think. Okay, is there some questions? No, not you, someone else.
I don't have a question. I would like to request you, you were speaking about the age and what to do and how difficult it is sometimes to tolerate the when you get a little bit elder. But maybe you like to tell us something about how you was coming in contact with Krishna consciousness, maybe about your youth.
Yeah, my youth, yeah. Yeah, it happened a long time ago. No, I had this, I was, how it was now? Yeah, I was not so happy, and I had a Bible actually. I was not raised in a religious way. We went to church once a year. My mother brought us there before. We call it First Advent. I don't know, First Advent. It's like 4 weeks before Christmas. So we had to go that, and I, yeah. But I had a Bible, and one time I put it on some table and then knelt down and prayed that My parents should not suffer for what I had done, or something like that. And just after that, I was sitting on the pubs in Göteborg drinking beer. And when when I get home from my evening, so I put on the radio. So they call it Neo Radio, a different non-profit organization. At that time it was mainly Christian sect, so to say, to get programs in the evening or the whole day. But I always put it on. It was Christian preaching, but I put it off after half a minute or 1 minute or something. I could not stand preaching, but I was looking for something. And one evening I came home at 12 o'clock, and I put on the radio. It was Radio Krishna. I never heard about such thing. At that time, I wanted to have many ears, and then they sent from the 12 o'clock in the evening or the night to 5 o'clock in the morning. And I could not stop listening. They talked about reincarnation and karma and everything. Many other things I was some thinking about also. So, and the people could call in and ask questions. And the person who was answering, he was very calm and very straight answers from Bhagavad Gita and from Srimad Bhagavatam, and it was such clear. One got clear on this, not clear, but it was so profound or something. Yeah, I cannot find it. Yeah, so that's how it started, and then I was very hesitant to visit their preaching center. I went there once, but I didn't dare to go up. I felt so ashamed or whatever. But eventually I went up there and they were nice. So that's how I started Krishna consciousness. But I was also, I didn't also feel that it was for me. I had this, the devotees, they looked so bright and they were so advanced, but yeah.
Yeah, Archie was making her hands up. She will ask or say something.
Okay.
Yeah. I wanted to ask, why is it so difficult to get out of Maya?
Why is it so difficult to get out of Maya? No, it's Krishna's energy. Yeah, no, it's our desires. We have these desires. And I think personally, like, Krishna has no so much trouble with us having desires. It's just because we know Krishna will fulfill our desires, but we should wait for Krishna to arrange that and not strive by our own endeavor. We should just do our duties So then next question is, what is my duty? But who can say? It's different for different persons. So it's desires, but my feeling is that Krishna has no problems with our desires, but we have Krishna's problems when we shut out Krishna or push Krishna aside and try to fulfill our desires and separate it from Krishna. Because it will take some time. We cannot just expect that everything will go away just like this. That we think in the beginning, we think it will go very fast. Yeah, it's another thing also. Prabhupada always said, chant Hare Krishna and be happy. And we may sometimes, we're chanting and sometimes we feel happy and sometimes we feel not so happy, and then we think, I'm supposed to be happy. Yeah, and I have heard one metaphor, very nice metaphor. It's like, so you have two patients in a hospital. One has a diagnose and one has not a diagnose. Who is happy?
The one without diagnosis. That's wrong answer.
Yeah. Yeah, sure. I've told you.
Yeah.
Because let's analyze. If I don't have a diagnosis. Pardon?
I will be afraid.
Yeah, you are in ignorance. You know nothing. You know nothing. But if you have a diagnosis, then yeah, there's some relief. You know, yeah. If I follow, of course, if it's a nice Ayurvedic doctor. But if you follow, then you know you will become happy or become sane or whatever, frisk,
cured.
Yeah. So we have to find happiness even in our suffering. No, it's kind of, that is a mystical thing actually, to find this. Because life is suffering, we cannot avoid it. I was thinking quite recently also, because my body has been very good physically. My problem was most in the mental thing, but body has been nice, even if it's abused in some way. But nowadays, something is coming. Now I lost the thread here. Okay.
About the healthy, that you feel some kind of happiness. About the happiness.
Yeah, happiness. Suffering. Yeah. So I was thinking, we see when you go to the church, so you see Jesus Christ is hanging on the cross, and for me it is a statement. Yeah, life is suffering. We have to not be so. Life is suffering, but anyway, it's worth living. We have to find out that place, even if suffering. We have to find something worth living for, and we can always find that. This is a very deep thing. That is what all religions is about. In the suffering, I find something worth living for. worth dying for, actually. Yeah. Okay.
I'd like to ask about this Krishna radio. Was it a local radio? Or I remember in the 80s.
Yeah, this was in the 80s in Sweden. Yeah, and they had it for some.
I made the first trip to Scandinavia, come from East Berlin, East Germany, and make this first trip in the 85 or 6 or something, and I visit, I'm not sure, in Bergen or in Göteborg.
Did you know Prabhupada? No. Prabhupada, no.
Prabhupada was, I don't remember exactly the names. But they show me a small studio and they make the kind of radio. Maybe the bosses. Yeah?
Maybe in Stockholm, maybe in Göteborg. Maybe in Göteborg.
Stockholm, no, it was.
No, then it was in Göteborg, yeah. They made, I built that little studio down in their villa. You were there?
Yeah, in the 80s.
Oh, yeah. No, they had this Radio Krishna, yeah.
Yeah, our first trip, we go up to Stockholm and then to Helsinki, but then there's a ship back to Stockholm.
At that time it was many devotees, and it was very passion, very much talking. Yeah, so we know also this passion, it goes down. When we are in ignorance, what do we do? Pardon? We use passion to come out of ignorance. We do something, not just lying. No, when we are depressed, we do something. You clean the floor or something, or do something for someone else. Immediately you come up. And then with the mood of passion, you should use to come up to the mood of goodness. And then I think this We should preach more about the moods, how to get out of these moods and come to, because at, when I came to Krishna consciousness, it was like this. You chant Hare Krishna and become, and be transcendental. As soon as you had a problem, be transcendental, Prabhu. I mean, I was thinking, I mean, you cannot jump from ignorance to so it's a gradual process, and it's also, gradual process, and you have to do it every day. There is one word in Bhagavad Gita, abhyasa, abhyasa yogi. Abhyasa yogi, it's mentioned many times in 6th chapter and 8th and 12th chapter, and I recently read somewhere else also. So it's abhyasa means repetitive. That's why we chant every day chanting. Every day chanting and every day doing something. It's repetitive, it's very important. Mm. It's not that one just chant one day 64 rounds and then take rest for rest on. So did you, did I answer your question or no? No?
I think it's a complicated question maybe.
No, the process is there. We have to follow, like you get instruction from the doctor and you will get cured. Okay, so.
Can I just mention something in just a small story? We are all Krishna devotees, actually.
All out.
Oh, we are all Krishna devotees, that you all know. But we have done some good thing in our previous lives. That's why Krishna has taken us under his protection. So we don't have to worry anything about things. Have you all heard the story about the footprints on the sand? No. There was a devotee, he was a great devotee, and he leaves his body and he goes up. And he's sitting with the God, and God and he are looking at his life. The God says, there you were born. And then they are walking on the seashore, on the sand. You can see two footprints, God's and the devotees. And they were walking and walking. God says, there you were born, there your parents, there you grew up, and then here you got married and had family. And suddenly the devotee could see only one set of footprints. Then the devotee turns to God and says, oh my God, that was the time I had a lot of problems. Why did you leave me? Then the God says, those footprints are mine. Because you had so much problem, I was carrying you in my arms. So don't worry, he's always there, carrying you in his arms. Sorry.
Thank you. Someone have one question or thought? Okay.
You were talking about the verse you learned when you were going to Stockholm. Which verse was that?
Well, let's see if I remember it now. Fifteen. How does it start? 15:15. No one. Krishna. Okay. Yeah. So my brain starts. It still starts also not to work so nicely. But anyway, I can translate it. From me comes remembrance, forgetfulness, and. It does. Remember what is it? Anyway, I forget. Okay, forget. Okay, I will mention another verse instead. It's from Srimad Bhagavatam. In the end of Srimad Bhagavatam, Kalir Dosha Nidharajan Asteko Mahaguru Kirtana Deva Krishnasya Mukta Sangha Param Varadhyat. It means in this Kali Yuga there is Mahaguna. Guna means qualities, Maha means great quality. Kirtana Deva Krishnasya, to sing the glories of the holy name. Mukta Sangha Param Varadhyat, so we can get the highest perfection. So this is very important Verse. Okay, thank you.
Sarvasya
sham riddhi sannivisto matta smriti jnanam apohanam sha vedai sha sarvair aham eva vedya vedanta krit veda eva chaham. Microphone, yeah. Sarvasya chaham riddhi sannivisto matta smriti jnanam apohanam sha vedai sha sarvair aham eva vedya vedanta krit veda eva chaham. So, oh, I can read the German. Ich weile im Herzen jedes Lebewesens und von ihr kommen Erinnerung, Wissen, yes, knowledge, and Vergessen. Das Ziel aller Wählen ist es, mich zu erkennen. Wahrlich, ich bin der Verfasser des Vedanta und ich bin der Kenner der Veda.
Okay, very good, and then in English.
Yeah, but I should not. Thank you, yeah. I'm seated in everyone's heart, and from me comes remembrance, knowledge, and forgetfulness. By all the Vedas, I am to be known. Indeed, I'm the compiler of Vedanta, and I am the knower of the Vedas. It's a very nice verse, and there's many nice verses in the Bhagavad Gita. Some more questions or thoughts? Okay, so, okay.
Yeah, well, regarding your question, I was just thinking regarding... Well, regarding the question which was asked here, why it is so difficult to come out of Maya, I just had a thought. It's, Maya is great. No? It's a big energy of Krishna. So, and actually, as far as I remember, we are incapable of surpassing it by our own force. It's impossible. We cannot overcome Maya ourselves. And as you said, so right. It's. We defeat our ignorance by going to the mode of passion. We defeat the mode of passion by going to the mode of goodness. No? But that's not the only one. It only really works if we use this energy for Krishna service. And then we really can advance. And actually, it's not us advancing, it's Krishna pulling us out. So, and in this way, I think. If we put our own energy to Krishna's service, then he just gets us out, because he is already waiting for us. He's there. He loves us. That's why he created us. So he's waiting, and by doing service, which is actually the only way to get out of everything, then Krishna comes and helps us, gives us the hand, and gets us out. And well. On this way, we can realize how big is Maya, and in this way, we can realize how big is Krishna. And this makes us humble. That means that develops inside ourselves the quality to be really able to serve Krishna. Because if I look at myself now, I'm a pretty arrogant type. And I'm not able to serve Krishna, because I have so many ideas on my own how things have to be. But actually, to serve Krishna, if I follow what my guru says, it's to be ready to do what he wants and let your own ideas aside. And well, on this process we learn just that.
This was a nice point, that we can realize how big Maya is. Yeah, then we become a little more afraid of Maya, because that's all maybe. Or shortcoming, we are not really afraid of Maya. Or we also, this is our mind. The mind is the problem, because the mind oscillates between should I do, should not do, or do or not do. So we are always. So we should try to come to a fixed mind. Fixed mind. Yeah. But we need a guru. We need. Prabhupada, we need to study the scriptures also. It's very important. Okay, I read another verse. So about Maya, this is from the 7th chapter. Dabi shaguna mayi, mama maya duratyaya, mami vaye prabhagyante, maya mitam tarantite. This divine energy of mine, consisting of the three modes of material nature, is difficult to overcome. But those who have surrendered unto me can easily cross beyond it. So this is a little answer to your question. It's like Patita said, but we can show Krishna that we want, and then Krishna will help. Okay?
Questions, please ask.
Mahali,
please read 9:34
also. 9:34. Yeah, I think that everyone
knows.
No. Okay. Yeah, Krishna speaks. Not, of course, he repeats all the points again and again, but there's a few verses he kind of repeats, and this one is 9:34, is one of these verses. The same verse comes back in the 18th chapter also. Mamana Bhavavad Bhakto Madhyaji Mamna Maskuru Mami Vaishasis Yuktvaivam Atmanam Matparayana. Engage your mind always in thinking of me, offer obeisances and worship me. Being completely absorbed in me, surely you will come to me. So this he will repeat also in the 18th chapter. Of course in the 18th chapter is a summary of the Bhagavad Gita also. But so, but it's special, it's almost exactly the same verse in the 18th chapter also. So I will just say something more. I started with saying time goes very fast, and it's inconceivable how everything is working or how everything is going on. But generally, we we think that we have so much time, but we don't really have so much time. Time goes quick. So, thank you.